Good morning, students. Today you have a English lecture, and today we'll do lesson number 4.5, and the name of the lesson is The Old Man and the Sea, a book review. See, here is a lesson, The Old Man and the Sea, book review. Now let us see first what you are going to see in this lesson. Now, this is a review of the book The Old Man and the Sea by Ernest Hemingway. So, this lesson is written by Ernest Hemingway. Now, let us see what you are going to see in this book. Now, this is a review of Ernest Hemingway's book The Old Man and the Sea. We have an old, experienced Cuban fisherman unable to catch fish for 84 days. Now, Cuban is a place. And in this book or in this novel, there was a fisherman from Cuban who was not able to catch fish for 84 days. He goes far out at sea and hooks a marlin. Now, see a marlin. What is marlin? Marlin is any large saltwater fish, marlin. The struggle of the man with the fish is the gist of the story. So, what's the gist of the story? How he had the struggle with the fish, the fisherman. Hemingway's had the experience of fishing. He talks about the struggle against defeat and death and the need of determination and endurance to win against struggles in life. So, how a person struggles in life to achieve something. The character in the book is shown going through suffering and loss, but finally sees triumph. Sees triumph means what? Finally he wins. There's a struggling in the starting, but finally he wins. Hemingway's writing style is applauded. Applauded means what? His work is appreciated. Is one of the greatest works. Now let us read the lesson. Students, please pay attention. An old man, an experienced Cuban fisherman, has a run of terrible bad luck and is unable to catch any fish for 84 days. So this Cuban fisherman was not able to catch a fish for how many days? For 84 days. His young and devoted apprentice. Now what do you mean by apprentice? A person who works for another in order to learn a trade is known as apprentice. A person who works for somebody else to learn the trade. Manolin, so who was the apprentice? Manolin has been forced by his parents to start working with another fisherman. So this small Manolin, his parents had forced him to work with another fisherman. The old man resolves to sail out further than all the other fishermen and attempt to catch their really big fish. Means what? If you go deep inside the sea, you will be able to catch a big fishes. On the 85th day, he succeeds in hooking a marlin. So, for 84 days, they were not able to catch a fish. But on the 85th day, they succeed to catch a fish. And the name of the fish was what? Marlin. Marlin. Marlin with his bait. But the marlin is too strong. See, a marlin is what? Any large saltwater game fish. Too strong for him and starts pulling the boat. So this marlin who was caught in the hook was very strong fish. The Old Man and the Sea is a story of old man struggling with the marlin and his later battle against sharks. You know, sharks also are found in the sea. Now, social historical context. Hemingway's novel is based on real events. So this author, his novels are based on real events or real stories. And it also draws heavenly on his own life, and sometimes he write about his own life also. He had experience of fishing in the Cuban waters, and like the old man, he was also a fan of a baseball. Baseball, you know, it's one type of game. So he was fond of this baseball. He worked for the Red Cross during the First World War and was injured by shrapnel when he was in Italy. Now, what is shrapnel? A hollow projectile containing bullets or the like, and a bursting charge designed to explode before reaching the target, that is used in the war. Hemingway always talks about the need to struggle and against defeat or death. So he had lot of struggle in his life, and he talks about defeat and death and how determination and endurance can help one to win in this struggle, and you should have a strong determination to win any struggle. The old man is at the end of the novel, very near death, but we know that the story of his suffering and loss will live on the memories of the people of his village. So when he was struggling in life, he said, when there is suffering and loss, people will remember the stories in a better way. Ultimately, his story becomes one of triumph. Triumph means what? After struggling in life, he had a victory. That is called triumph, because the tales of his life will live on even after his death. So even when this author is dead, people will remember what good deeds or how he has won victory over defeat will be remembered. The novel was published in 1952 when people were trying to recover from the mass destruction wrought by the two world wars. So during those days, world wars had taken place, World War I and World War II, and how he struggled in life and he became a winner. Right means what? Worked. And this tale of endurance and ultimate triumph immediately struck a chord with the readers. Now, what was the writing style of Hemingway's? Now, writing style. Hemingway's language is simple. He used a very simple language and pithy. Pithy means what? Brief, full of vigor. He mostly writes in short and straightforward sentences and practices an extreme economy in his use of words. So his writing is very simple and he uses his word very carefully. The simplicity is deceptive, and the reader can read his work again and find new layers of meaning every time. So when you read his book, you feel like reading, and something meaningful thoughts are there in his book. Now, my thoughts. I first read this novel years ago when I did not understand it at all and was left impressed. See, when you read a book for the first time, you are not interested. But when you read the book and try to understand, you will feel like reading. So here he says, I first read the novel years ago when I did not understand it all and was left impressed. Means after reading, he was not impressed. He was not happy. In spite of this, vivid image remained with me. An old man holding on to his fishing line with the last of his strength. Recently, I read this book again and was extremely moved. So when he read the book again, he was extremely moved. Means he felt something. The formidable. Now formidable means what? Causing fear. Strength of the old man's character. The quiet devotion of the empathic Manolin and the relationship between the two are heartwarming. Okay, you know how this Manolin struggled to catch a fish. Hemingway's description of the sea and the creatures of the water are beautiful. the Merlin fights for his life. Merlin is a fish. How the fish fights for his life desperately. And it is hard to know whether our sympathies should lie with the old man or with the Merlin. But as the novel progresses, the old man and the Merlin are inseparably linked because both stand for the same ideals that is a noble struggle against destruction. So both Merlin and the old fisherman had a very struggling life. And why they had a struggling life? Because they had some to achieve in life. So hope so, student, you have understood this lesson, The Old Man and the Sea, a book review. Thank you, students.